So this, as our final story of the week, do we, you know, we need more sound effects in this program. Heather, can you like give a drum roll or something over there? Pretty good. She's pretty good at that. What is the final story?
It's one of those things you wonder why they didn't think of it sooner. There, one school in Florida is taking a leaf out of the Paleo Dieters book, and they are standing up while they're learning.
A school in Palm Coast, Florida is the first in the U.S. to experiment with a new classroom technique, specialized desks made for standing up. This classroom at Belterre Elementary is called Rise. In here, students are piloting the new LearnFit desks, accompanied by iPads. Choice Media got to have a look inside the class via Skype.
It's better than the old bulky desks. The only thing I wish it had was a slot where you could put stuff in, but they're working on that.
Belterre's assistant principal, Anna Crawford, explained some of the benefits of the LearnFit desks.
What we started to look at this year with our LearnFit desk was, you know, we're starting to see obese children. So we wanted to look at a way to combat that obesity. And also, we're trying to find ways that our kids are more comfortable in our classroom. So we're big on active learning environments. What can we do to, you know, increase their productivity, which is also, we wanted to look at versatility in the classroom and outside of the classroom, as well as mobility.
In addition to the standing desks, the students also appreciate having one piece of technology, their iPads, in place of several heavy textbooks.
I don't want to keep like 1,000 papers in my, I can keep like billions and billions and billions of things in here, and I don't have to go searching through the thing. I can just go to the search bar and type in the note name, like 7.7, and I can get all my classwork that I've been working on.
What about your book bag? Has that been heavy this year?
No.
No.
Though the students have the option to sit down if they get tired, most of them choose not to, and seem to thoroughly enjoy this innovative style of learning.
I would like to see them in classes all over America.
Awesome.
And so the young Carl Sagan there going with the billions and billions.
Billions and billions.
Right. And he's right. Why shouldn't there be a little place to put your stuff under there?
Yeah, like, that's the one kid, flaw in the design.
Yeah, that's right.
It's still being piloted, so.
I mean, look, I guess I'm happy to see that any kind of innovation could be going on in a school of assignment, in a zip code school. Jonathan, what's your stance on stand-up desks?
Well, look, I have a little boy, and imagine, you know, telling an 8-year-old, okay, sit still for 6 hours.
Yeah.
We'll talk to you later. So, no, it is a wonder that they haven't thought of something like this earlier. I think it's great.
And they say the kids like it, and the teachers like it. Everyone seems to like it. So, it's amazing to think that something like this would have not been tried before. I guess maybe someone just said that. Maybe you said that. Looking particularly smart and dapper, Jonathan Butcher today with the bow tie. That's why. He's got the bow tie on. That makes him extra smart. Our thanks to the executive director of the Goldwater Institute for joining us on today's episode of Reform. Thank you.
My pleasure.
All right. And for Chris and Heather and Alex, and where did Allison go? She went over there? Oh, she's in the office. Hey, thank you. So here I'm Bob Bowden. Not that you care, the viewers. We'd like to give you these updates behind the scenes. We'll see you next time.